Throughout the history, film industry has been playing a pivotal role in social and political transformation throughout affecting habits, way of thinking and laws, or supporting the change procedure and spreading it. Film are considered as a strong weapons back to the 19th century. Films were used for political propaganda, especially during the Soviet Union times, where they're used to be a ministry of propaganda called the Ministry of Cinema. In Tunisia, after the independence in 1960, the president, Habib Bourguiba, used cinema for social change, education, overcoming the effect of the French colonialism in order to build and maintain the Tunisian and African identity. In 1966, the Ministry of Culture inaugurated the first film festival in the Arab and African region called Carthage Film Festival, which celebrates this year his 54 years. The Tunisian Federation of Cine Clubs and the Federation of Cinema Amateur contributed in the foundation of this festival. The main reason behind this festival establishing for this festival was to educate the Tunisian people about their own culture, social change, education, and women's rights, which reflect on nowadays Tunisia is the most liberal region in the Arab country. The second reason was mainly geopolitical. The Tunisia is the most. The festival was meant to unify African and Arab, sharing knowledge in film industry from different culture, using films to highlight social issue and react to them, especially that the whole African continent was trying to overcome and recover from the colonialism. Film industry at that time was perceived in Tunisia as an important element, as mentioned before, for social change and development. However, it was never considered as a revolution weapon that can change the history of the country. In the beginning of 21st century, following the world globalization, the Tunisian film industry has developed and become easier for many filmmakers to produce many kinds of films, especially documentaries. In the time of the President Zine Abidine Ben Ali, right before the revolution, freedom of artistic expression was limited in addressing social issue, but never political, which was one of the elements that fueled the revolution. Many films and documentary films have contributed to the revolution of the people in 2010. Over social and political justice and freedom of expression in all its forms. After the revolution, censorship was completely removed. Film funding has become fair and shared among all filmmakers equally and without any red lines. All this has contributed to an important evolution of cinema industry. The film production increased. The number of festivals has also increased. Example, every month, a festival in Tunisia in general. Many facilities and advantages were offered in order to encourage investment in film industry. Also, Tunisian film have become present in the biggest festival in the world, such as Cannes Film Festival, Venice Film Festival, and Berlinale also. Every year, at least one Tunisian film is participating. Now I will talk about a film, and thanks to all these changes, the artistic and cultural life in Tunisia was given breath and again, and people started to participate into the field. social issue has become relevant to everyone. In 2017, a documentary film called Open the Shadow participated in our festival, Carthage Film Festival, and won the Tanit Prize. Then it participates also in other world festival. This film deals with the homosexuality issue, which is punished by the law for up to 3 years in jail. And it was screening in all the cinema theaters in Tunisia, in the country, which led a large audience compassion. Neda Hafayed Mezni, the director of the film, follows the life of the former feminine member, Amina Sboui, and the community of LGBTQ friends she houses, which she houses in her Tunisian house, offering unparalleled insight into life following in the Arab Spring, social persecution and political struggle from a queer perspective. So I will make this to show, yes. The sound, This is the trailer of the film.
Go to the slide before.
Okay.
And sorry for this.
No problem. Okay.
مستحيل نسامح تخاف على بنتك ما تعطيش بنتك حري مش تقتلها ولا خشخاش هذا كله على تصويره
ساعات نحب نحكي مع ربي يعني بالحق نحب نسمعه يعني وجاوبني
والطير تشد والطير تشد بلا
حبيت معناها دارنا يخفى معنا معناها خاطر توا في ريسك فهمت لي؟
ليش تبقى صغير يعني ما فهمت شيء من السلطة حالة
اخرج يا ما منش فضلك عليك راه يا سزبي يا سزبي اخرج نايك
so after the now I will talk about Mawjoudin Queer Film Festival. The slogan of the festival it's the first ever LGBT film festival in Tunisia and also in the Arab region. And the slogan in we are trying to fight not only in the court but throughout art. Gay rights activists have emerged from the shadows since the revolution in 2011. Despite being homosexual, can face up to 3 years in prison. Article 220 of the penal code, including a punishment of up to 3 years in prison for homosexuality, and young men are regularly detained and prosecuted. Shams Radio, an online radio station catering to the LGBT community, began broadcasting in December 2017. The aim of this radio is to create a space to talk about LGBT issue and sexual abuse in relation to the expression of gender and sexual identity in schools, as well as the discrimination endured by youths in forced marriage. A few weeks later, the first Arab film festival to support these minorities was launched and tackled thorny issue to defend this group, often marginalized and vulnerable to social and moral harassment by the authority and others. Mawjoudin Queen Film Festival is organized by Mawjoudin Arabic for the, We Exist Mawjoudin. We Exist is the translation of Arabic word. A Tunisian non-governmental association founded in 2014, which defend the rights of lesbian, gays, bisexual, and transgender people, LGBT. The films in this festival, programming in this festival, speak about sexuality, identity, and gender affiliation. And the first edition of the festival was held in Tunis in 2018. The sites of the festival culture activity were only revealed by word of mouth, so that police and security officers would not be able to obstruct this film event. Through this festival, they would like to give space to queer people in general in order to escape a bit from social pressure and also to identify with something, find a means to express themselves. We are different, but we exist, and difference are welcome, said Sinda Benjbara, a member of Mawjoudin. The festival also included panel discussion about art and queer resistance. This discussion between specialists allowed the public to understand better what being a queer means, as well as the link between politics and the LGBTQ community. In the first session in 2018, morning seminars were held, the first entitled Queer as Art, to discuss the relationship between sexual orientation and art, and the second entitled Queer and Resistance, to talk about the daily resistance action to those who are forced to be different in the Arab world and the Middle East. The program included photography classes and performance for theater reading, as well as musical performance. This festival, which is an attractive forum towards a real and constructive discussion of this issue of freedom in Tunisia, is the extent of its reality and where its borders lie. All this through the culture, art, and artistic discourse as a form of expression does not end its validity throughout the ages. Mawjoudin Queer Film Festival is back for its second edition. It was in 2019 and aiming to cover the full LGBTQA spectrum and have a strong focus on feminism. A total of 31 films were shown, including Argentinian, Chinese, Pakistani, Indian, and also Tunisian film. In addition to films, there are also performance and theater workshop titles towards a queer theater. The third edition will take place in Tunis next month, March, between 20 and 23, thank you. This is to the poster of the first edition, and this is the poster of the second edition. Thank you.